When I was 13 or 14 years old, I can't quite remember, but I was young. My mother told me a story. And I have two older brothers who, my middle brother was a twin, so I always knew that his twin didn't make it. And they said that that twin was a girl. But she had told me in 1961 that she was actually pregnant with her first child, which is older than my oldest brother. She had gone into labor, and unfortunately, the baby didn't survive. Asked later on, I don't think at that moment, I think because I just felt sad for my mom, that how did she make it through losing a child? Because it just doesn't seem natural to lose a child. And what do you say to someone who's lost a child? I had a friend who lost a child, and I just really didn't know what to say. And so my mom told me that there are really no words that can express the sorrow from losing a loved one at all. But she did share that, you write prayer, an ear to listen, a hand to hold, and that's what you could do. I think several years after one of my friends had lost a child, I had another friend whose child devastatingly was in a very bad accident and passed away as well. I just couldn't imagine, and I would always say, no parent should ever have to bury their child, no matter how young or how old. It's been a little over 2 months. And I had to do just that. My youngest son was named Beau Martin Stephen, and he lived 31 years and 32 days. It was a sudden loss. It wasn't expected at all. I've had many people say different things to me. Of course, the obvious, how you doing? You need to talk. My prayers are with you. Give me a hug. And I just want to say thank you for all of those kind words, gestures, prayers. This is all still very raw and our kids, my kids, my husband and my kids, you know, they just, it's unreal for them. We use the word unreal because if you knew my son, he was strong and funny. And inspiring, and he struggled at times, and all through the pandemic I was scared for him because, you know, with job loss and everything, which he loved his job, that takes a toll on people's mental health. But at the time he was working, he was thriving, he was happy. But there were some things that were going on. And I'm so very lucky that I was able to talk to him the day before. I think about those words and what we said and what he shared. You just never know, you know, what's gonna happen from minute to minute. So October was always the hardest month for me because my mother was born, it's her birthday month, and my father also passed away in October. August always seemed, or July and August primarily, we have a lot of celebrations and birthdays and activities. But it'll now be also a time of remembrance for my son. July, the month he was born, and August, the month he passed away. So the day before my son passed away, we talked. And there were a lot of things that needed to be said. Cried. We laughed. We discussed deep things. And we discussed nonsense things. Just as we always had in the past. One of the things we did discuss was, you know, me on YouTube and him on TikTok. We were working on, he was getting monetized on TikTok. And so he shared himself, and he had also had a YouTube channel years ago, where he did his workouts and stuff. He was big into muscles and working out and get me to do all kinds of exercises and things. Said he wanted to keep me around for a while. And he recorded music on SoundCloud. He was very much put himself out there. But he had a deep inner turmoil that he had a hard time with. And so while we don't know everything that happened at this time, I know from that last phone call that he still had many things to finish with his time on earth. Now I truly believe that he's continuing as he watches over us. I wrote a poem for him to share at the memorial. He would constantly say, "That's right, that's right. Something good happened in your life, like, that's right." You know, he was happy. He was happy for other people. He always wanted to see people succeed and have the best in life. I'm going to share the poem that I wrote for him called "That's Right." You were a surprise for the family, a beautiful surprise you were. You made our family complete with your beautiful soul near. We watched you grow from child to man, exploring life on your own terms as only you can. You bless us as a son, grandson, brother, nephew, uncle, father, and friend. Hearing you say, that's right, will be ingrained in all of us again and again. You professed your dreams and made them come true. You told me you wouldn't live past 35. I didn't believe that was true. We are doing our best without you here. You wanted to be a guardian angel before we were ready to bear. You wouldn't want us to weep, instead have a drink, and remember all your crazy deeds. As you were the life of the party, sharing your presence for the world to see, allowing us to have those memories for all eternity. We promise to fulfill your dreams you left and ensure your children fulfill theirs too. We now have you as our guardian angel to guide us from heaven above as you told us you would do. We won't say goodbye or farewell, but see you on the other side. God bless you, my son, and good night. We love you. That's right. That's right.
If your absence doesn't bother them, your presence never meant anything.
Yeah, that's sad, but you gotta be a lone wolf out here. You gotta take chances. You gotta be that person. When the struggles of life hit you, when it's friends, family, relationships, whatever it is, the losses of life create character, perseverance, strength, and power. And one more thing, you're not alone. Isaiah 41. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Amen.
Behold, the fields where I grow my fucks. As you could see, it's barren, because I have no fucks to give. Yee!